So you become dependent. You are on crutches. People say, I am independent. You are not. Only a person who is a devotee of the Lord is actually independent. Because he is not dependent on anything which is material. Whereas if you surrender into the material energy of the Lord, you are every time dependent and more dependent. But when you surrender to Krishna, you become independent. But remember one thing, independent, the word independent has got the word dependent in it. It's made in dependent. You are not dependent, you are inside the dependence. That means when you are totally dependent to the Supreme Lord, the internal energy of the Lord, what happens? You become independent. Otherwise, you become dependent. So here, Prabhupada, and who is happy? A dependent person or an independent person? We get dependent on our vices. We can't leave things. Person who smokes, it's so difficult. Drinking tea. Oh my God. You talk to a youngster also, it's so difficult for him. Arey Baba, how many years have you lived in this body, in this present incarnation of your, when you're carnated into this body? You still can't give up. See how dependent you are? You don't get a cup of tea in the morning. What happens? You run around. Such a small thing. There is chaos in the house in the morning if the head of the family does not get his cup of tea. Right or wrong? Or if the father shouts like mad. So Pavan was telling me, if his father doesn't get the morning cup of tea, he'll bring the house down. So try to understand this. This is a very important line which Prabhupada has picked up, stated to us. They wrongly think that by advancement of material comforts, every man will be happy. Dependent also means that you are bound, right? Dependence also means what? You are bound. And independent means you are not bound. Not bound by the jail. A person like you outside, we are living outside. We are not in the jail. We are not independent in the sense that we follow the laws of the country. Right or wrong? Right? But we are not forced to follow. We are following it on our own. But person who is forcing himself to follow the laws, will he be happy? No. So we have to practice. In spiritual life also the laws are there. Initially because when you depend on Krishna, depend means what? Surrender. Surrender means to follow the orders. Order means again dependent clutches. But if you follow it not by force, but you want to follow them, like the laws and the traffic. Traffic rules are a simple thing. If everyone thinks it, that it is good to follow traffic rules, will there be any accidents? No. If everyone I'm talking about, if one of the person also thinks, it's useless to follow them, what happens? You have accidents and loss of life. Right or wrong? So please understand. So you want to become happy. Want to become independent. So develop spiritual knowledge. When you develop spiritual knowledge, what will happen? That comforts, if they come, then also you are not dependent. If they don't come, then also you are not dependent. That means you are every time you will be happy. And that's what your goal of life is. Next, Prabhupada says, they have no knowledge that the material or external nature is very strong. For everyone is strongly bound by the stringent laws of material nature. You have to understand one thing. That these material laws are also not easy to break. They are very, very difficult. The biggest thing is this, they are difficult. Why are they so difficult to break? Because they are very attractive. The material comforts are very attractive. They can entice anyone. The greatest yogis also, get enticed by the material energy of the Lord, the external energy of the Lord. So Prabhupada says that they have no knowledge that the material and external energy is very strong, for everyone is strongly bound by the stringent laws of material nature. What are the stringent laws of material nature? The most stringent is birth, death, old age and problems, diseases. These are the stringent laws of nature. Can you break them? No. You are forced to take birth. You are forced to die. You are forced to grow old. You are forced to face problems, diseases, right or wrong. A living entity is happily the part and parcel of the Lord, and thus his natural function is to render immediate service to the Lord. When is the living entity? Living entity means soul. When is the soul happy? When it acts in its natural position, natural situation. What it is natural situation is? To serve the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Lord Krishna. That is its natural condition. Like the natural condition of the fish is to live in, take it out of the water and give it a very big palace to live, 1,000 rooms, 10,000 servants, breakfast 1,000 dishes, lunch 5,000 dishes. Will the fish be happy? What will the fish say? Put me back into my natural surroundings. That is water. By the spell of illusion, one tries to be happy by serving his personal sense gratification in different forms, which will never make him happy. Now, what is the illusion? Illusion means what? Yes, what you think it to be, it is not that. Appears, but it is not. Simple. The spell of illusion. So, illusion has got a spell. You say, magic spell. He is under the spell. Under the spell of illusion, one tries to be happy. One is not happy, but he is trying to be happy by serving his personal sense gratification. Your senses are there. What are you trying to do today? Gratify means? Satisfy. You want to gratify, you want to satisfy your senses. Your senses, eyes, you want to see good, beautiful things, go to the movie. Hear nonsense, see nonsense, smell nonsense, eat, drink nonsense, use the tongue for nonsense activities, speaking nonsense. And we think it will give us happiness. No, they're not. They're not going to give you happiness. Because the nature, try to understand, the senses don't enjoy. It is actually the mind who is enjoying. Because the mind is the king of the senses. There are 5 senses. Eyes, nose, skin, ear, tongue. And the king is the mind. So whatever the, in a kingdom, what are the subjects do? The benefit goes to the king. So actually the real enjoyer is the king, the mind. And the nature of the mind is to never be satisfied. You are trying to satisfy something whose nature is not to be satisfied. And other point, try to understand one thing. I am talking on the mind control. When we talk of mind control, how does it come about? It is very simple. Please try to understand the relationship. Mind, the nature of mind is to be not to be satisfied. One. Number two, the sense objects and the senses are stated to be, senses are stated to be the to be fire, and sense objects are stated to be fuel. Now if you add fuel to the fire, will the fire get extinguished or will it burn more? It will burn more. So what should you do with the senses and the mind? give it as much it is required. Stated na, God provides for everyone's needs but not for his greed. So fulfill the need, not the greed. If you want to make dal, you require small burner, or do you require furnace? Greed will finish you. It is like a furnace. When you try fulfilling your greed, you are finished. Because greed will bring about jealousy, peer pressure, everything, tension, everything follows. But if you are living for your need, you are controlling your mind. Otherwise, the mind is controlling you. Now, would you like to be controlled by your mind or control your mind? But is it possible? If you are moving according to the dictates of the mind, if you are moving according to the dictates of the mind, you are under the control of mind. And Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita in the 6th chapter that mind which is under the under control, under your control, is your best friend, and the mind by which you are controlled is your worst enemy. Now, should we look out for the enemy outside or inside? Inside. Your best friend is outside or inside?
Inside.
So now learn to make the mind your friend. How? By controlling the mind. But how do you do that? Because the mind, since infinite number of births, we have fed it so much that it has become so strong. Remember one thing, when you die, only this body remains here. But the subtle body, which is made of mind, intelligence and false ego, is never finished. It carries on, and it becoming stronger and stronger and stronger. And it becomes so strong that you actually in front of the mind are really got no strength. We should say strength. We got no strength whatsoever. So what should we do then in such a case? If some big pehlwan comes into your house and tries to throw you out, and you know you can't fight with him, he's a big don, politician don, then to finished, hai na? If it is a don, politician don, then to you are finished. Then no chance. If he's a don, there is some chance. But if he's a politician don, then you're finished. So then whom should you look out for? Someone who is much more powerful than this person, and go and surrender to him, right or wrong? So in the same way, this mind is not easy to control, but it becomes very easy to control if we surrender to Lord Shri Krishna. Surrender to Lord Shri Krishna means to surrender to his instructions. Or basically, surrendering means to follow his instructions. But before following his instructions, you'll have to believe that he is the Supreme Lord. Otherwise, your belief in his instructions, your faith in his instructions will not be there. And if the faith is not there, then what will happen? Sometimes you will follow and sometimes you will not follow. So that is why you have to surrender to him. Surrender to someone like Srila Prabhupada. Follow his instructions. It is not easy. Big sannyasis have fallen down. And many who are sannyasis are still fallen down because they have still got desires of enjoying this nature. It is not easy to give up. Prabhupada is stating here very clearly, only a pure devotee of the Lord can represent the Lord. So when you surrender to such a representative, that's what we are doing.